Finally tonight, Jon Stewart finds humor and humanity in a most unlikely place and in a very new way. Jeffrey Brown is back with a look at the new film, Rosewater.
You must not just take his blood, Javadi. You must take his hope.
In 2009, Maziar Bahari was held for 118 days in solitary confinement in a Tehran prison, a very real ordeal dramatized in the new film, Rosewater. Bahari was a Canadian citizen who'd returned to his native Iran as a journalist working for Western media organizations. His assignment to cover a momentous election that would end in mass demonstrations and mass arrests, after reformer Mir Hussein Mousavi's challenge to President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad ended in a defeat widely condemned and discredited as fraudulent.
What's he got to be afraid of?
The film shows how Bahari, played by actor Gael Garcia Bernal, met and interviewed protagonists on both sides before being arrested and charged as a spy. He then endures interrogation by a man known only as Rosewater. One bit of absurdist evidence, an actual appearance in a Tehran cafe that Bahari had made on the Comedy Central program, The Daily Show.
What do I have in common with you?
Who is number one enemy of the United States?
Al-Qaeda.
Al-Qaeda is also the number one enemy of Iran.
And then you're going to back up and just go out of frame that way.
That connection and the courage and humor shown by Bahari, even in the face of torture, drew the real-life host of The Daily Show, Jon Stewart, to the story and to his first foray into directing a feature film.
Here's what I want to accomplish right now. Let's talk.
The two would become good friends and then collaborators. They told me about it when we met earlier this week at the museum in Washington.
It was compelling in the generational aspects of it, in his family, the fact that his father had suffered a similar fate under the Shah. His sister had suffered it under Khomeini. He had suffered under Khamenei. These are regimes that are some Western allied, some enemies of the West, all using authority to suppress their people and building these apparatuses.
When they arrested me, the questions were not about what I was doing. It was, you have to tell us how did you put this politician in touch with the British embassy? How did you put this politician in touch with the CIA? And I didn't know what to say. So in the absence of any evidence to implicate me, they brought forward this ridiculous evidence, including my appearance on The Daily Show.
If someone wants to weaponize something innocuous, they're going to do it, whether it's the something banal that you've given them or something else.
It's absurd, right?
The interrogator.
It was as if they had read Kafka and they thought it's a good manual to, have run a regime like that. And then they thought it's not absurd enough, so let's just add a little bit of Monty Python to Kafka.
In his more familiar day job, of course, Jon Stewart tackles all kinds of topical issues, but the humor is very much in your face. It's a comedy show, after all.
The Democrats got taken out back and old yellered by the American electorate.
He took 3 months off from The Daily Show to shoot his film, most of it in Jordan, including in a real prison.
Was it hard for you to play it straight?
No, because the humor of it, so much of the humor in it is what appealed to me. Maziar's ability to, in some ways he's the canary in the coal mine for things that I believe, that even in the darkest time, humor is one of those elements that you can retain your sense of humanity with. It can give you some comfort and act as some defense. There's sometimes a misperception, I think, of satire, that it is clownish in the sense of, no disrespect to clowns, but that it's baggy pants farce. It's not. It's a way of expressing ideas and synthesize information that you truly believe in, just using the tools of satire.
Hey, Davoud! Wait, you've got to get hurt!
We have to fight back!
What are you doing?
Fighting back!
In the film, we see Bahari feeling he'd been forgotten and abandoned, not knowing that his family, employers, and political figures were waging a strong public campaign to get him released. Just days after that finally happened, his wife gave birth to their first child. He would write about it all in a memoir titled, Then They Came For Me.
In the film, we see that I humanize my interrogator, who's brutalizing me.
Who's also not presented as a monster.
Exactly. And not because of altruistic reasons, because of very selfish reasons, because if I regard him as a monster, I cannot defeat him. So when I'm, like many people who live in the West, when I'm stuck in the subway or the metro in DC and it's hot and it's crowded, I say, oh, it's torture. But then coming through that ordeal, I know that's not torture.
No. He's not saying it's pleasant.
I'm not saying pleasant, but it's not torture. Exactly.
And I read in another interview you did, you said, I consider The Daily Show and this movie a conversation that we are having with the culture and with people.
Yes, that's right.
What's the conversation, or what's the conversation about?
The conversation is about many different things. The conversation is about the space between the public face of our leaders versus the private strategies that produce that face, the facade that's placed up. The conversation is about corruption, whether it comes to governance or whether it comes to media. The conversation is about, you know, what is activism. This particular conversation is about the cost of oppression, and not just to Maziar, but to all the journalists and bloggers and activists who are being held.
It's interesting, you spend a lot of time lampooning journalists on your show, and then you've made a film where you're really honoring a journalist.
Right, which seems completely logical.
It does.
Well, absolutely, yeah. Because the satire comes from a place of urging. It comes from a place of an ideal. Mm-hmm. It's the humor only works as a counterpoint to seeing something that you feel is not at the level where you know it could be, of opportunity squandered.
And you now devote your life to press freedom issues?
Part of my life, yeah. Yes. We have...
He also goes out to eat some.
He does.
Yeah.
Yes. I am one of the privileged people who work for the Western media. People knew my name. Many of my friends and colleagues in Iran and in different countries, they do not have that international profile. So I have the responsibility to talk on their behalf and try to raise their profile.
And you have gone back to your day job.
Still have my parking space, yeah. So that
still have your parking space.
Yeah, that's right.
And are you going to keep that? I mean, does this...
Why would you hear about my parking space? am I losing that?
Has this changed your thinking about your own future, about what you'd like to do?
I think it just, again, reinforces the idea of it as a longer journey, that it's not so much, it's continuing to work on projects that I'm interested in and believe something is important to talk about with.
All right. Jon Stewart, Maziar Bahari. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
We have more of Jeff's interview, including Jon Stewart's take on the importance of satire in his storytelling and how he came to direct Rosewater. Find those clips on ArtBeat.